Welcome to Bertrand Peabody's Holiday Special. We're going to get started. I'd just like to ask everyone to go ahead and silence your cell phones right now. So if you could just take a minute to do that in respect to all of the work that our students have done on preparing this awesome show for you. And then I'd like to also ask that you keep the aisles clear because we will be moving about in the auditorium. So if you are sitting in an aisle right now, please go ahead and find a seat, actually in a seat. Okay, and we're going to get started. Thank you.
Thank you. gentlemen, boys and girls of all ages, I'm your host, Bertrand Peabody, and I would like to welcome you to a celebration of joy, cheer, and all-around good vibrations. From our host to yours, season's greetings, and let's get this over with. Our first number this evening is a timeless classic. Unfortunately, we don't have the stamina to perform the whole song at once, and frankly, you don't have the stamina to listen to it. Everyone, please welcome with me the Spinaldi sisters as they sing the first installment in 12 part series of this long-winded carol.
On the first day of Christmas, my true love gave to me a partridge in a pear tree.
Right, Bill. As we all know, the holidays are a busy time for everyone. Matilda, I told you not tonight. As I was saying, the holidays... Matilda, don't make a scene in front of all of these nice people.
Bertrand!
Matilda, get off!
My one verse!
Let's go. Off the stage.
Anyways, the holidays are a busy time for everyone. All that hustle and bustle down the street, Christmas shopping, baking, seeing relatives, dealing with tinsel, why it makes me sick just thinking about it. How about you? This next little lady is here to give you some creative ideas to blow off some steam during those stressful holiday preparations. Hi there, Holly.
Well, hello, Bertram.
I hear you have a special number for us this evening. Why don't you tell us a little bit more about how you like to relax during Christmas?
Well, Bert, after I get done with all of my holiday baking, I like to take a nice big tray of cookies and eat them alone in front of the TV.
Wonderful. What do you watch?
Oh, Bert, the TV's turned off. My cable's been disconnected.
Terrific.
And then when I get done with those, I like to take a nice gallon of chocolate milk and just wash it all down.
Your own special recipe?
That's right. 4 parts milk, 1 part brown food coloring.
Why, that's disgusting, Holly.
Oh, it really is. This song isn't about what I like to do to relax in the holidays, but what I've heard some people do. Sleigh bells ringing, are you listening? In the lane, snow is glistening. A beautiful sight, we're happy tonight. Walking in a winter wonderland. Gone away is a bluebird.
Patience. My dad said I was a test tube baby. He wanted me to have a womb with a view. My dad loves whiteboards. He says they're remarkable.
I'm out of here.
So my dad went bald and I asked him, where exactly do you stop washing your face? The doctor asked my dad for his blood type. He said red. One year for Christmas, he gave my brother a bag of broken glass, and he gave me a box of Band-Aids, and he said, now you boys share. He opened a restaurant on the moon. Great food. No atmosphere. No atmosphere. The waitress came to our table one night and noticed my dad hadn't finished his food. She said, you want a box for that? He said, no, but I'll wrestle you for it.
Night was that terrible. Looking for that perfect gift for your special someone? Tired of spending too much money on generic things like perfume and jewelry? Need something that says, I love you and I want to help? Give her the gift of Colgate Total.
For me? Oh, you're the best.
I have a better idea. Let's take this bad boy for a spin.
Colgate Total fights cavities and prevents halitosis, so your girlfriend can enjoy healthy teeth, and you can enjoy being around her.
I wish I had this a long time ago.
So do I.
Here's the toothbrush for best results.
Did it talk about those garlic knots?
No, but you did.
Toothpaste, it's for the both of you. Now back to Bertrand Peabody's holiday special.
Welcome back, folks. For those of you just tuning in, I'm your host, Bertrand Peabody, and let's get right into it. If you're anything like me, the holidays are a huge reminder of how disappointing your life has been. In that vein, I would like to read one of my favorite poems, The Road Not Taken by Robert Frost. Two red steppers in a yellow wood.
Enough already, oy vey.
Excuse me, I'm reading a poem here.
Not that poem, you're not.
Who are you anyways?
It's me, Phyllis. Phyllis Spitzer, your producer, 59.
Aren't you dead?
Of course I'm dead, Jamani. Would you wear this if I had a choice?
My goodness, Phyllis, how are you?
I am terrible. Let me tell you, show business in the afterlife is no piece of cake. But I'm not here to talk about me. You. You're a mess. Don't act like you don't know what I'm talking about. You're falling apart out here and it's Christmas for Pete's sake. And you're killing me with this poem, and that says a lot, because I'm already dead.
Now, Phyllis, you know how I feel about the holidays.
Yeah, I do. Now all these people do too. Bertrand, we can't ruin Christmas for everybody.
I can certainly try.
Listen, kid. I used to hate the holidays too, and for good reason. My great aunt Gertie used to make me drink her homemade eggnog at her on the go parties.
That's just disgusting.
Yes, it was. But look at me now. Forced to wander the earth alone, and in this dress, why, if I could go back and enjoy all the love and devotion that went to that disgusting eggnog, I would. You know, I could also go for a nice onion bagel with some shmia.
Really?
Something about this holiday has you in a terrible mood, Bertram, and I'm being curious.
Now, Phyllis, I don't need your help. I don't like Christmas, and that's that. I don't need anyone poking around in my head telling me why. Now, don't mind, I have a poem to finish.
Over my dead body. Let's talk about it. Tonight, you can visit my three pals of mine. They'll come with you. Matt, what are you doing? You said to come when you least expect them.
You were supposed to come in after I left.
Oh. I suppose that makes more sense.
I was never here!
Listen, Bert, you can't teach a dead actor's new tricks. All right, carry on with the show.
So what do you want to do? Oh, I don't know what I'm doing.
My apologies, ladies and gentlemen, for that extended interruption. Now, let's get back to the next segment of our show. The holidays are a time for red, green, and white. And I know what you're thinking, but I'm not talking about the Italian flag. No. I'm talking about candy canes, Christmas trees, and snow. This next guest is here to give you some creative ideas for decorating at the holidays.
Oh, Mom's Day!
Delightful.
Oh, Bertram, this suit is just to die for. So understated.
You look wonderful as usual, Blair. Love the dress.
Oh, merci, or thank you, as they say in Canada.
And in the United States, too.
Oh, of course they do, you sweet simple man. Now about this dress, or roblette, as Margot Feeney likes to call it. This is something I made myself from the feathers of 1,000 bolts of coming pigeons.
Really?
Why, yes. Just a little project for those rainy days when I can't go riding my rocking stallion, Auguste. As a matter of fact, I brought a portrait with me. Isn't he just delightful?
Oh yeah, he has beautiful teeth.
I'll put him in your trailer.
You don't need to do that.
I do.
Now how are you, Bertram? No, John Hamlet. I'm going to read your aura. Yes, just as I thought. Just the night was a blend of malaise and purple and canary yellow.
What does that mean?
Oh, Bertram, you're such a card. Oh, just look at this fabulous scene. Oh, it's so organic. The sheen is wonderful, Bertram. Just exotic.
Won't you have a seat, Blair?
Oh, yes. Let me just adjust the chair so it can light up my mood pathway. There, perfection. Oh, Bertram, you haven't changed a bit.
I am Madge, the ghost of Christmas past.
Bertram, you're back.
I've come to remind you of what was what. Oh, what was once.
You need to leave.
Was
no, I'm getting a very strong spiritual sense here, Bertram. My dear,
I've come to show Bertram how he used to feel about Christmas. Behold! Oh, Bertram, just look at all the snow!
This is the most wonderful time of the year, isn't it? Yes. May I sing to you?
Sure.
Sally, I have a question for you.
Oh, Bertram, darling, I can't. I'm sorry.
But why not?
I'm becoming a nun.
What?
A nun. I'm sure I mentioned it.
And I'm sure I'd remember if you had.
No, I definitely said something. I even wore my habit a few months ago.
Habit? I thought that was just a Halloween costume. So what about us?
I told you I was leaving after Christmas.
That was a joke.
I wasn't laughing, Bertram. You were the one laughing.
What's going on?
Bertram, I care about you a great deal, but you have some denial issues. Merry Christmas, darling!
How terrible. You have to spend another trial by fire. No wonder you're so wounded.
Bertram, we don't have any time for your flashbacks. This is a live show. Let's go to commercial!
Blair, I'm so sorry. We're going to have to cut throughout for a second.
No apologies. I simply thrive on these spiritual revelations. Bertram, you have a lot to work through. I'm always on the move right away. Remember, as they say in Bavaria, wenn das Leben sei Tronen, plans, and obstacles give time. Life is giving you lemons. Start an organic lemon orchard. I think you know what I mean. Oh, and Bertram, this is the red tie. It's a little goat.
It's a little goat.
Is your outdoorsman hard to shop for?
Yes.
Do you find yourself aimlessly wandering the department store aisles, unable to find that special something?
Yes.
This year, give him the gift of Charmin Ultra Strong.
Say, I never never thought of that.
That's right, little lady. Treat your man to the luxurious toilet paper that's just too expensive to buy the rest of the year. With every use, he'll not only feel pampered, but also extra manly, knowing that he's using the strongest toilet paper on the market.
It's ultra strong, just like my man.
Charmin ultra strong, the man who has everything.
Hello, and welcome back to Bertrand Peabody's Holiday Special. I'm your host, Bertrand Peabody, and I hate this. Due to some technical difficulties, we will be expediting some sections of our show tonight. Everybody, please welcome with me the Spinaldi sisters, as they sing not three, but seven verses of that captivating old tune, The 12th Day of Christmas. No matter how many times I hear that song, I will never understand it. Our next guest. Potatoes patootie! If you don't get off the stage right now, I'm gonna get unprofessional!
Cut! 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 Matilda, what is this?
I just want to sing O Holy Night, but no one will ever let me!
That's because you have the voice of a bullfrog and the grace of a herd of water buffalo!
Why don't you go take that?
I'll be in my trailer!
Does this mean I get to sing?
No, honey. Bertram may be Catholic, but he's definitely not tone deaf.
Can I just do one little verse?
Come on. Let's go. You need one.
Ah! Leave me alone! No! I don't like it!
Will you listen for one gosh darn second? I am the ghost of Christmas presents. I mean presents. The fairy tale is happening right now. I am the current day ghost.
What do you want?
I want to show you what's happening right now.
I already know what's happening right now.
Will you please watch? Please. Sometimes we need to see the pain we cause when we are blinded by our hurt and disappointment. You don't like the holidays because they remind you of what someone did to you. But look at Matilda. She just wanted to sing, but you hurt her feelings because you were only thinking about yourself. Yes, I did it. I said the whole thing.
Yeah, well, why does everyone else get to be happy and I have to be miserable? And if I have to see another ghost tonight, I'm going to have a stroke.
Excuse me, Mr. Peabody. It's time for our next bit, I think. We lost Beverly. She's been hospitalized for overexertion because of that last verse. But we want to still on contract. That's right, we signed up for 12 verses.
Looks like they're going to need you. I'm going to off take. I mean take off. I don't know what I mean. I need an aspirin.
Me too. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome again with me the Spinaldi sisters. Natalie's sister has
fallen.
Can we get some help out here?
Let's go to commercial!
And now, ladies and gentlemen, we proudly present Donovan Smith, who holds the world record for the longest time jumping rope. He has jumped rope in over 30 countries and can jump while eating a spaghetti dinner. His motto is, jump with your heart. When I first started, I'm sorry. This is the wrong milk cart. I spilled Ovaltine all over my desk earlier, and now everything's all mixed up.
Aw, oh, man.
Oh, man, I'm glad I can't be fired. Oh, okay, here we are. Aw, oh, how fitting. Looking for that perfect holiday beverage? Need to be the jumping something both delicious and nutritious? This year, fill your kitchen with cheer and your glasses with Ovaltine.
Ovaltine makes a special treat. Just mix and stir and your little elves will thank you.
Everyone want a glass of that silky smooth goodness. Why, instead of milk, why not leave Santa a nice tall drink of Ovaltine with his tray of cookies on Christmas Eve?
Say, that's a swell idea.
Yes, it is. Ovaltine, it's all over my desk.
Welcome back, folks. For those of you just tuning in, I'm your host, Bertrand Peabody, and my life is falling apart. Something we all love during the holidays is the wonderful sound of Christmas music. Don't you enjoy tuning into the radio and hearing the same 5 songs at every station? If you're anything like me, it makes you want to rip your ears off. Good cheer and good times. Ladies and gentlemen, would you now please welcome with me the talented Miss Kelsey Stevens. Oh, the magic of bubbles. Speaking of magic, isn't there a lot of it this time of year? Well, it seems like everywhere you turn, everything is disappearing. Money, waistlines, the hot chocolate packets backstage. Seriously, who's taking all the hot chocolate packets?
Bertrand!
Yes? What? Oh no, you don't. What are you doing here?
I'm a blind portal! You can call me Bart for short. I'm the ghost of Christmas future! I can tell I got here not a minute too soon. I think it's time for a shave, Sonny.
I'm over here.
Oh, of course you are. Now listen up!
Over here.
Well, stop running around the place like a wild banshee! Skinny little fellow, aren't you?
You were saying?
Well, I mean, you just seem a little undernourished is all. Put some meat on your bones.
No, I mean, what are you doing here? Let's get this over with. And I'm over here, by the way.
No need to get fresh, Sonny! Get your attention over here. I'm gonna show you your future Christmases.
I'm Bertrand Peabody, and here's your Channel 2 weather forecast. We're gonna have a significant bit of rain coming in from the Central Coast. It's gonna hit us good and hard first thing Christmas morning. In other words, the weather's gonna be as bad as the holiday.
What? Channel 2 weatherman? What is this, some kind of sick joke?
It's no joke, Sonny. It's your future.
But I am THE Bertrand Peabody. Everyone loves me. I have my own show. I'm the best in the business.
After tonight, you're not. In just a few months, you're gonna have a nervous breakdown and try to slam TV place Trace in.
You mean that slimy good-for-nothing that's always trying to get my job?
Mm-hmm. And he'll get it too if you can't change how you feel about the holiday. Can't do that, he's gonna get your job, and you'll end up a total celebrity failure. Forgotten. On Channel 2.
That is never going to happen. If you don't mind, I don't even want to talk about this anymore.
You could turn it around, Sonny. You just have to fix what you broke. You can't do that by the time this special's over. There's no turning back.
I don't believe any of that. Now, if you don't mind, I have a show to announce.
Could you point me to the door, Sonny?
It's on your left.
Thanks.
That way. My apologies, ladies and gentlemen, for this extended interruption. Now, let's get back to it. I'd like to invite the last standing Spinaldi sister to sing that final version. Performing the next number, wait for it, on skates. That's right, folks. These lovely ladies are experts out on the rink, and now they're here for your enjoyment. Edna Fleming and the Tennessee Two. Edna Fleming and the Tennessee Two. Mike? Is that you? Where's Edna?
Edna's got hives, but this is her last seen more greyhound than in Vegas.
Oh, Mike, you handsome devil. Always making him funny.
I'm serious, Bert. Nobody seems this morning.
Well, then, would you excuse me for just 1 minute? What is happening? Why me? Please continue. My butt off to make my name. But what do I get? People fading, EMTs rushing in, ghosts trying to psychoanalyze me like I'm some sort of monster. I'm not a monster. I'm a really great person, and everyone loves me.
Actually, I'm happy I'm dead.
Looks like this show's as terrible as it's always been.
Oh well, look who decided to grace us with his presence, everybody. Timmy Blake! Well, season's greetings, Timbers, but this is my show! Mine!
That's not what the director said.
What?
You're fired.
Oh. I think under my gentle guidance, this show can get back on the proverbial road.
Never! Never! Never!
Come on, go forward.
What's your hair, Bertrand? Don't you sew your snowsuit?
I'll have you know that this snowsuit from Neiman Marcus, and it wasn't cheap. That's it.
Just then, Bertrand Peabody remembered the words he had heard from Blind Bart less than an hour before.
In just a few moments, you're gonna have a nervous breakdown and try to slap Timmy Blaine's face in. But you can turn it around, Sonny. You just have to fix what you broke. If you can't do that by the time this special's over, there's no turning back.
Pause. Weighing his options. Tempting as it was, could it be that punching Timmy Blaine's perfect face wasn't the right thing to do? Should he stop and fix all the relationships he'd broken that night? Could it be that this action would inevitably send him into a spiral that will seal his fate as a weatherman on Channel 2? Would he regret this moment for all eternity? There is only one way to find out. As it turns out, Bertrand Peabody wasn't cut out for the holidays. Some people just aren't. But that doesn't have to ruin it for the rest of us.
Get away from me!
Get back here!